You can ask Google almost anything. Anything except the future. We can't predict what's going to happen tomorrow, but we can observe what's going on today. Today, 3 billion people are online. That's almost half of the world's population. In many parts of the world, people are not just online once in a while. They're online every single day. But that's not as surprising as how we're online. Across ages and nationalities, more and more people use smartphones to go online. Like her. And him. And them. And this little guy. In the United States, there are now more people who prefer to use their smartphone instead of their computer and tablet. This is also the case for people in India, Italy, Spain, and many other countries. And in Korea, people are 10 times more likely to go online on smartphones than on computers and tablets. Whereas the digital age started with a computer for many people, newcomers to the internet today skip this step, going straight to mobile. 90% of Thais under 35 use smartphones, while only 40% also use computers. Only every fourth smartphone user in South Africa owns a computer, and 2 out of 3 smartphone users in India don't have a computer. Smartphones are becoming man's new best friend all over the world. More than 300 million people got their very first smartphone last year. That corresponds to 10% of all online users. We already think mobile first. Should we start thinking mobile only? The number of connected devices per person is on the rise, and that changes the way we spend time together. At an ordinary evening at an Irish family, for instance, 2 out of 3 family members go online on their own device while watching TV. The youngest family members prefer using their smartphones as their second screen, while the older generation is more likely to use a tablet. Actually, most of the internet usage is not related to the TV program they're watching. People have different tastes, but does that mean we can't be together? With the whole world accessible by our fingertips, we are not only entertaining ourselves, we also educate ourselves like never before. In several countries, more than 75% of the population under 35 go to the internet when they need information. How will that change the education of the next generation? And how do we become wiser when we already have all the world's knowledge at hand? The internet has changed the lives of the first 3 billion people online. How will it change the lives of the next 5? Data inspires us to see what questions we need to ask.